New York City, ranked number one as the most expensive city in the world. In other words, it's the one city you can go broke very easily unless you have a decently high-paying job and live below your means. Which I did, until recently. So a few months ago, I made a video on interviewing strangers in New York to ask them what their dream jobs are. And then I realized I was asking other people what their job is during the time when I was supposed to be working mine. And that's when I realized this job was not it for me. Ever since I graduated in 2020, I've been in a weird place where I feel like I keep pursuing things I don't want to pursue. A part of me thinks it's because I want that safety of just having a job, especially a high-paying job. And I just like want to get the ball rolling, be financially stable, and invest my money. I guess in other words, what I want is comfort. It's been a few weeks of being jobless now, and I've just been trying to make the best use of my time. Honestly, it's been one huge roller coaster because I first felt scared, and then somehow I just started to feel at peace.
Red Mercedes, attitude like fuck you pay me. Roll it deeper than Adele when we go out. If the ladies show up, then we show out. With my girl in my red Mercedes, attitude like fuck me baby. Leather seat so she wetter than a pool now. When that thing go up, then she go down.
This shit so clean, I put that on my life. Red Mercedes green, it's a different type. This shit so clean, yeah, put that on my life. Yeah, from Mercedes green, it's a different type.
With gray nada, yes, I'm the baba. Don't rock Prada, what's a stylist? I'd rather make my clothes merch by the boatload. Banana club popping, yup, I'm super biased. Tint so black, look like my complexion. Neo, I'm the one, like I had direction. Rims look like they was shipped from heaven. Trunk so big, it could fit my reverend. Yeah, and that nigga's pretty big. Engine so fast, every block is a trip. Baby girl wish that I copped a two-seater, but I had to get five, cause my niggas wanna ride. With my niggas in my red Mercedes, attitude like fuck you pay me. Roll it deeper than Adele when we go out. If the ladies show up, then we show out. With my girl in my red Mercedes, attitude like fuck me baby. Leather seat so she wetter than a pool now. When that thing go up, then she go down.
This shit so clean, I put that on my life. Red Mercedes green, it's a different type. This shit so clean, yeah, put that on my life.
Hello guys. Wait, I want to show you guys this really cool light that I got. Look how cute this is. It was custom made and it took 3 months to get it made and delivered to me, but honestly, it's amazing. Like, it makes the room a lot warmer, which I really love because it just fits my aesthetic more. Oh, and then I also have this new keyboard, this desk setup. I like the color of the desk mat because it's like a matcha color, which I love. Alrighty, let's get back to it. So I pretty much like started to feel a bit bored just not working. Like honestly, it's so interesting because when I was working a full-time job, if you know me, I have longed to be an entrepreneur. One major thing that I've learned is that nothing is perfect in life, meaning there are always going to be trade-offs, and that's something that I really had to just sit with. But the reality is that you have to learn how to be satisfied in the moment, because actually everything is a trade-off. Like, maybe being an entrepreneur, like, maybe that will make me a bit happier, who knows. But I also have to sit in with the idea that there are going to be cons of being an entrepreneur. So now I really question if doing full-time YouTube is right for me. I still want to get monetized on YouTube, but I want to have it as like a side income and still keep a 9-to-5 job, because there are still things I've missed from having a 9-to-5 job, like the accountability I was talking about, and also like to be able to work with people, and also just having other people push you to get out of your comfort zone, for you to learn so much, right? Because when you're an entrepreneur, you have to do so much learning on your own. Like, no one is there to share ideas with you. And so that collaborative environment is something that I very much miss. One of the biggest reasons why I wanted to be an entrepreneur in the first place, if I really think about it like subconsciously, is I wanted to prove to myself and to others, particularly my parents, that I'm capable of making money on my own. So I just wanted to let you guys know that if you have different passion projects that you're really actively working on and you really want to grow your platform, I say do it. But if you also want that stability of having a full-time job at a company, do that too. So because of these like newfound discoveries for myself, I realized that I want to get back on the job hunt again. I think it's so important to make sure to find a job that really aligns with what you want to do long term. So with that said, I am super stoked to share that I got a pretty good job at a pretty big tech company. But I won't be disclosing that in this video. I'll probably disclose it in my next video. So anyways, be sure to stick around if you want to follow my journey, and I'll see you guys in the next video.